Hello and welcome. Today I'd like to show you my ultimate air hose reel combination. So not only is it an air hose, but we've also got two lines of 30 amp 220 and four lines of 20 amp 110. And all of this runs through this reel up top. We got a plug here for the 110 and a 60 amp plug there for the 220. So we've got all our electricity running through what's known as the slip ring up here and going through the junction box, going down to a plug for the 110 and a plug for the 220. And our air reel just goes through a standard flexible air coupling on the other side. Now let's take a look inside and see what actually makes this thing work. So here's a little look at the magic behind the electrical side of this reel. I've got what's known as a slip ring. I got this off of eBay from Hurricane Wind Power. These are typically used in wind turbines to transmit power from the generator on top of the tower down to the ground. So you can see we've got six wires on one end, six wires on the other, but you'll notice as I turn this, it can turn completely freely. Now, if I just had a cable sticking out of this reel, it would whip around and get all twisted up. But these slip rings have these wires going to a set of contacts inside that brush up against the outer wall and transmit, you know, one leg to its corresponding output. So this is what's going to make the electric side of this reel work. Once again, they're called slip rings. Really neat. These are all 12 gauge wires and each one's rated to 30 amps. So that fits right up inside a bushing that I turned down, and I chopped off one side that looked just like this, had NPT threads on it, and had another one of these elbows for air. Chopped that off, turned this bushing, you know, milled out a little slot, TIG welded that all the way around to this piece of solid stock, welded the little bushing back on so it catches the bearings right, and painted it all up, and then this slip ring will fit right inside there. So here's how that slip ring fits up. Just got a press fit with some Loctite. And then the wires come out of there. They're soldered onto the wires in this SO cord. Heat shrunk, electrical tape, friction tape, everything, the works. Here's a look at what this cable looks like. Kind of funky stuff. Seven conductors in one SO cord. So six 12 gauge wires and one 10. So this way, with this number of wires, I can carry two 220 circuits for my inverter welders, and I can carry a 110 line as well. So here we've got the reel mounted up, the junction box, going to that slip ring. We got the dual air power cords coming out. And then got another junction box right there. And that splits off into a welder outlet and two pigtails. We've got a MIG. And then we've got a stick over there. We're able to run both of them at the same time, whatever amperage we need. And it's really handy because when you're done, you just unplug everything and reel it back up. So that's all there is to it. Drop a comment down below. Any questions, comments, and concerns, throw those down below. And check us out on Instagram for all the behind the scenes work and the in-process restoration photos. Otherwise, thanks for watching, work hard, and stay humble.